If I traded it all.
So happy holidays to everybody out there. Welcome to the show. We are having fun over here at KFNX. We've been having a little Christmas party over here, and we've also been networking already with everybody. And as all of you know, I made it possible for everybody to talk about themselves. Maybe next year, get yourself on Networking Arizona. I'm going to go in with networking right away with my first guest. I have a lot of newbies here today, so it's going to be really fun with me. I have with me Darren Permenter, and he's the owner of Adobe Property Inspections. Welcome to the show. You got to tell everybody a little bit about yourself, and happy holidays to you.
Well, thanks, and happy holidays to you, Carol. I'm born and raised here. I'm a native Arizona native Phoenician, third generation, actually. So,
wow.
My blood is thin and my skin is thick, so too many sunburns. But I got the chance to see the valley grow all these years, and I just love architecture. I love building, so that's what really got me into it.
Well, you had said before you came on that you have a story because of the fact that you are a third generation native Arizonian. You said that your grandfather, someone was a carpenter, so
yes.
Kind of gave you where you are today. Go ahead.
Yes, I was born a carpenter's son. I guess 'tis the season for that, right? My dad was a carpenter, and I remember early on going to when he would build the houses, and I would work for a can of soda, but lining out the homes, watching the framing going on. Those guys work so hard out there building these homes and have built our city so well. But little things like I remember, I think I was in high school when they started putting in man-made lakes out south of South Mountain, and they said, yeah, they're going to build houses out here. Like, no way. No one's going to live way out there in the desert. Well, now it's all Watukee.
Yep.
And, of course, the same thing happened up in Arrowhead region where they're going to tear down all these beautiful trees and put in man-made lakes. So, and now it's Arrowhead. So, mm-hmm. Things like that I've been able to see. I feel blessed to see the valley grow and really sort of feel a part of the whole intricacy of building.
But more than that, mm-hmm. when you are a property inspection mm-hmm. person, such as yourself, it gives you, because you have the knowledge of the way a home should be built, or you will see things that other people might not.
And from the ground up, realistically, from the building materials that they use, and I think I feel like I have a good insight on how that house is built. I've spent a long time into the trades in all different aspects of the trades over the years. So, I think I bring a certain quality and a different look on how I'm doing my inspections.
Okay, so let's talk about how you do them. Number one, are you valley-wide?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you're A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau, you had said. And your website is Adobe Property Inspections with an S.
Correct.
.com. You can call him direct at 602-349-2539. So, okay, let's actually talk about what a property inspection person such as yourself actually does cover.
Well, the property inspection itself will cover everything structural, from the roof to the floor, and of course anything electrical, plumbing, all of the wiring, windows, doors. So we're looking at every aspect of that. For the state of Arizona, they follow the ASHI report, so we utilize that, which is a nationwide report. So we check boxes, we go through everything, and we make sure everything's sound.
Mm-hmm. Are you both residential and commercial?
Absolutely.
Okay. And so what's the difference between doing a residential home and a commercial property?
Size. Yeah, quite a lot.
He said it, not me.
Size matters, and it does. It is quite significant on that. There are certain things that the commercial inspection will be upheld and accountable at a different level. Because now you're dealing with a lot more OSHA requirements and things like that you have to look at.
Is it required for people to have an inspection done?
No, but it's highly advised.
Exactly. That's why I asked. So, because, if they don't, what could happen?
Well, I've never seen the perfect house yet.
Mm-hmm.
Still looking for that. And whether it's a new build or a resale house, there's a lot of things that you can't see. We use the term in the industry, putting lipstick on a pig. And quite often you can have these homes that are being resold that just have a ton of paint on the outside. They look good to the prospective buyer, but then they can hire a home inspector to come and take a look and find those things behind the scenes. You know?
And so the time to call them you is when?
In resale, you have a 10-day window. When you put in an offer and the contract is accepted, you have a 10-day window to call and hire an inspector and get that done. And that gets the ball rolling with the rest of the resale stuff.
Mm-hmm.
There's other ways to use an inspector that people might not be aware of, and that's for new builds, the one-year warranty. So right now, if you bought a home 11 months ago, you're coming up on your one-year warranty from the builder. So now's the time when you want to get that home inspector in to sort of pick apart what the builder does. You know, I try not to say that I'm there to pick apart what the builder is, more or less just between my inspection and the builder warranty, give the customer the best product.
Right. Well, here's the thing. I mean, it's been almost a year now that they've been there and they're basically new home, yeah, making sure that everything is done properly so that now afterwards they don't have things to worry about. Is that correct?
Correct. Really protecting their investment, whether it's structurally, if something, foundational walls that are falling that they don't see, cracks in stucco, drywall. In that one-year warranty is really the only time in an inspection that we can really be picky as far as things, if doors and drawers aren't working and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
But there's always something, and it's... there's always something that's well worth it, because the homeowner doesn't want to have to pay for that later when they go to resell the house, so might as well have the builder be upheld really by what they're supposed to do.
His phone number is 602-349-2539. Valleywide, A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. He's licensed, bonded, and his website is Adobe Property Inspections with an S.com. What's a warranty home inspection?
That was what we were just talking about with the 1 year.
That's the warranty warrant. I'm
yes.
Sorry about that. What about a that's the one I was on. I missed it. It's a phase home inspection. What is that?
So a lot of people now are going to phase home inspections, and builders themselves are getting wise
to
this.
What is it?
Well, basically at each phase of the building, we come in and actually do an inspection
so
on the framing.
How many times
or just
can
the
that happen?
Right now, the best thing to do is two times. So we do a phase two inspection and a final inspection, and that way we find the things that are going wrong before the drywall gets up.
So let me say this: is do you think home inspections are valuable then to the home owner?
Absolutely. You know, back to I haven't found the perfect house yet. There's always something that is bringing more to the getting the house covered more than what you're paying for the inspection. They're always getting a value out of it.
Right. And so for you to come in, you say that education is a key.
Yes. You know, as a homeowner and being around in the valley and watching these things build and grow up, I love educating the buyer about what everything is. So I show them where the water meter is, how to turn off the water, how to turn off and on the electricity. What is it about their house that makes it special?
So, okay, are there any suggestions for homeowners to prepare for a resale in their home?
Yeah, there's three major ones, really. You spend a little bit of money buying anti-siphon valves, which are $5 a piece at Home Depot. Put those on all of your external hose bibs. Grab a tube of caulk. Caulk everything you can see. Any hole, just caulk it and let it be done. And then actually the high loops in the dishwasher, just pull that loop up, the drainage hose for the dishwasher, pull it up above the bottom level of the sink.
Well, you heard it from the best. The number to call him is 602-349-2539. He's Valleywide. He's A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. He's licensed and bonded. He does residential and commercial. It's Adobe Property Inspections.com.